Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to be discussing the angles of elevation and depression. This is a continuation of the series of problems we've been solving on trigonometric functions. So if you haven't seen the video on trigonometric functions, just click on the link at the top right hand corner of your screen. Okay, so angles of elevation and depression. What's an angle of elevation? Let's consider this man right here. Now, this man stands on a horizontal ground. So as it stands right here, he's got two eyes. So he's only going to be able to see what's along this line. It's called the line of sight. So let's assume that there is a building right here. So this man, this short man, is only going to be able to see this part of the building. So this is the top of the building. I'm going to call it B. Now, if this man intends seeing an object that's on this building, he's going to have to raise his eyes above this line of sight. So this is called the line of sight. This dashed line is the line of sight. So that's what the man is going to be able to see if he does not elevate his eyes. So to see what's at the top of the building, he's going to have to raise his head by a certain angle. At some point, he's going to be able to see perhaps this point. If he raises it further and further, he's going to keep raising it until he's able to see the top of the building. Now, this particular angle, I'm going to call it theta, is called the angle of elevation. The angle between the line of sight, because this is the new line of sight, and the previous one is going to be called the horizontal. The horizontal is the initial line of sight, what you are going to be able to see without elevating or depressing your eyes. So this is the new line of sight. So the angle between the horizontal, this horizontal line, and the line of sight that allows him to see the top of the building is called the angle of elevation. Let's have a similar diagram for depression. So we are still going to use the short man. Okay, so this is the short man. So as usual, this is the initial line of sight. He's only going to be able to see this. So let's assume that there is a building here. So the man and the building are on the same horizontal ground. So initially, this man is only going to be able to see this part of the building. Now, if he intends seeing the bottom of the building, he is going to have to like lower his head. So he's going to keep lowering his head at some points. So lowering the head at some points, he might be able to see this point, this point, this point. So he's going to keep reducing it until he's able to see the bottom of the building. So the angle, I'm going to represent it with theta. We shouldn't forget that this was our initial line of sight, but now we've obtained a new line of sight. So this is the new line of sight, and the initial one becomes the horizontal. Now this angle, which is theta, that the man needed to depress his head to see the bottom of the building is called the angle of depression. So here, the angle here is the angle of elevation, because the head was elevated, it was raised up. But here, the man needed to see the bottom of the building. So the angle here, theta, is the angle of depression. Okay, so we are going to be applying this knowledge to solve one or two problems. Here is the first one. So this is the first question. A woman, 1.6 meters tall, stood 50 meters away from the foot of a tower and observed that the angle of elevation of the top of the tower to be 50 degrees. What is the height of the tower? Now we know a tower to be a very tall building. So however tall the woman is, she's never going to stand a chance beside the tower. Now I have that the woman is 1.6 meters tall. So I'm just going to represent the woman with a straight line. So this is 1.65 meters. So I could call this W. This is the woman. She stands 50 meters away from the foot of a tower. So the tower is a very tall building. So this can represent the tower. I'm going to call the top T. Now both the woman and the tower are on the same horizontal ground. So they are going to have a horizontal distance. Now the distance is 50 meters. So the woman is 50 meters away from the foot of the tower. Okay, so she observed that the angle of elevation of the top of the tower to be 50 degrees. Like I said earlier, this is the woman's initial line of sight because she's only going to be able to see this part of the tower. But we have from the question that the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 50 degrees. That's our observation. So she needed to raise her head by 50 degrees in order to see the very top of the tower. So this angle between our line of sight and the horizontal, which was our initial line of sight, is 50 degrees. That's the angle of elevation. So we are asked to obtain the value of the height of the tower. So I'm going to call this X. So I'm going to call this F. This is the tower, TX. I can represent its height with the letter H. Now we can see here that this shape that's shaded in red is a rectangle. And one of the properties of a rectangle is that opposite sides are equal. By virtue of that, we would see that WF is going to have the same length as the distance between this point and X. I'm going to call the point point P. Therefore, WF is going to be the same as PX. So PX is going to be 1.65 because opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. Now, since the height of the tower is H and a portion of it is PX, then definitely the remaining part here, that's TP, is going to be equal to H minus 1.65 in meters. So if the entire tower has an height of H and a part of it is 1.65, then the remaining part is going to be H minus 1.65. So our interest is to obtain the height of the tower. So I'm just going to focus on this triangle here, the triangle TPW. Here is the triangle. So the angle at W is 50 degrees. TP is H minus 1.65 in meters. This is P. Now WP, of course, is going to be 50 meters because WFXP is a rectangle and opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. So our interest is to obtain the value of H. Now, this is where the trig functions come in. We've got a number of trig functions to pick from: the sine, the cosine, and the tangent. The sine is the ratio of the opposite to the hypotenuse. The cosine is the ratio of the adjacent to the hypotenuse, while the tangent is the ratio of the opposite to the adjacent. So let's see. This is a right triangle. Now, that makes this side, WT, to be the hypotenuse. Now, in relation to this angle, angle 50, the side TP is its opposite. So this is the opposite of angle 50 degrees, while the third side is going to be the adjacent of angle 50 degrees. Okay, so we've got the opposites and we have the adjacent. So we are going to use opposite adjacent, that's tangent. So tan 50 degrees is going to be equal to opposites, that's h minus 1.65 over the adjacent, which is 50 meters. Cross multiplying will fetch us h minus 1.65 because that's going to multiply 1. This is over 1. And the right is going to be 50 times tan 50. So this is 50 tan 50. Okay, so this is h minus 1.65. So the 50 is in degrees. So tan 50 is 1.1918. Multiplying 50 by 1.1918, I'm going to get 59.5877. So my left is still h minus 1.65. Collecting like times here, h is going to be 59.5877 plus 1.65. So h is going to be equal to 61.2377 meters. So we are not asked to approximate our answer, but I can just choose to approximate it correct to one decimal place. That's going to be 61.2 meters. So this is the height of the tower.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.